Hello, welcome to another edition of Momentum. I'm Robert Green, your host for this show. We're fortunate today to be joined by Mr. Calvin Walker. If you've been around aerospace engineering or Mississippi State for a while, I'm sure you have run across Mr. Walker. He is an instructor in our Department of Aerospace Engineering. Calvin, welcome.
Thank you.
Good to have you here.
Thank you for the intro. It's good to be here.
Good. So what brought you to MSU? You've been here for a while. What actually brought you to Mississippi
First time
State?
Or second time?
Let's do both.
Okay. First time, obviously, after high school. Looking to, my original thought was physics, and then it's like, you know, I really like airplanes. And then I saw they had an aerospace engineering program, so I decided to do that. But the second time, went to California, came back here and worked at a small company called Douglas Aircraft. Stayed around there for about 5 years and always wanted to get back to RASPIT. And so in 2002, joined out at RASPIT again as the senior flight test engineer and stayed out there until 2015 and then started teaching full-time in the department. So I've always liked RASPIT, always liked Mississippi State, so decided to come back. Never thought I would be doing this, but when the opportunity opened up, I decided to take it.
I think that happens to a lot of us. We come here for one reason and then end up doing things we never thought we would do. Well, what was it growing up that attracted you to engineering in general and aerospace engineering in particular?
Well, growing up, I put it to you this way. I had decided that I did not want to work in anybody's field. I picked cotton one time and decided that was not a thing for me. So I've always liked science and decided that I wanted to be some type of scientist or something of that nature. And so just like the normal kids, you know, although firemen and policemen are not sciences, but, you know, I went through that and then decided, well, how about marine biology? Then JAWS came out.
Okay.
And that ended that. And then I went oceanography, nope, JAWS. And then as I was going through, it was like, well, I like physics. And then, like I said, I got a pamphlet from Mississippi State on aerospace engineering. It's like, I've always liked airplanes, so I want to design the next airplane and decided to go into aerospace engineering. So that's why I'm in engineering.
Okay, well, that is an interesting story. You're not afraid of airplanes, but you are afraid of sharks.
So, yes.
Okay.
Yes. Airplanes, I understand. Sharks, I do not.
Understand. So you've taught several courses while you've been here, from senior design to dynamics and statics. What kind of courses do you teach? Which ones do you enjoy the most?
Well, let's see. I teach aircraft flight dynamics, which is basically the study of how an airplane moves after perturbation, aircraft performance and aircraft design, advanced performance, introduction to unmanned aircraft, systems, and I think I'm missing one. Oh, introduction to flight test engineering. Out of all of those, I think aircraft design is the one I really, really like. Just to see how students progress from getting an RFP or set of requirements and what they come up with from those particular requirements. So just kind of see the what they're thinking and how they're moving along. But aircraft design is like taking something or building something from quote unquote nothing. And so that's the one I really like.
What was your favorite one to take when you were a student?
Two, okay. Aircraft design. And at the time we called it flight two and flight three, which was stability and control in what I call flight dynamics today. So flight dynamics and aircraft design.
Okay. What kind of research did you do? You mentioned coming back to RASPIT. Of course, that's our RASPIT Flight Research Lab,
right,
a research unit here at the university. What type of research did you do there?
My main function was to act as the flight test engineer out there. Oversee the flying projects or the flight test projects that were going on out there. And so not necessarily what one would call research per se, but overseeing how the airplane flies and making sure that everything is in place so that when we go on a flight test mission that everyone knows what they're doing and so forth and so on. So I'll write the flight test plan, flight test cards, conduct the mission. So I'm the one on the radio talking to the pilot to make sure that they're staying on track. And then afterwards, working with the other flight, the other engineers to analyze the data and write the final report.
I think that's interesting because I know a lot of our students will talk about doing research. Mm-hmm. And of course, you immediately run to, or your mind runs to, okay, I'm going to be in the lab, I'm going to be solving equations,
right,
and doing all that. But you've hit on, I think, an important part of research and a lot of opportunity for students who are interested in research.
Mm-hmm.
Is more from the support perspective.
Right.
Sounds like that's what you did, was a lot of the, you were behind the scenes making sure a lot of the research actually happened.
Right. So, you know, from my role, it wasn't necessarily doing the fundamental research to find out why this thing or that thing is doing what it's doing. It's basically conducting the mission to support whatever we were doing at that particular time. And the airplane that we were using was the ULSP, so it's basically a sailplane. And we were looking to convert a sailplane to an optionally piloted aircraft. So that means the airplane will fly with the pilot in it, or it can fly on its own with the autopilot. So I guess technically that would be research, mm-hmm, but my main function was the conduction of the test.
Yeah, it's certainly an important part of conducting research. So for students who are interested in maybe not doing full-blown research.
Right.
There's a lot of support opportunities there. So I know our program has two concentrations, mm-hmm, one in aeronautics and one in astronautics.
Mm-hmm.
Can you tell us a little bit about those two programs? What are the similarities or differences?
Okay. Let me start with aeronautics because that's
okay.
The area that I'm in. So when you think aeronautics, think airplanes. How an airplane flies, the aerodynamics of making the airplane fly, the air loads that are on the airplane, how that airplane responds to different perturbations and so forth and so on. Astronautics think space. So rocketry or rockets, sending a satellite or a probe from Earth orbit to Mars and the moon. You know, we just did Artemis 1, not we, but the U.S. just conducted the Artemis 1 mission. So that's more is in the astronautics area. You still have to do the fundamental fundamental engineering in both concentration. You still have to take your statics, dynamics, fluid mechanics, and then it kind of branches off to where you're doing aircraft propulsion or rocket propulsion, aircraft flight dynamics or spacecraft flight spacecraft attitude dynamics, I'm sorry. So those type of things.
Yeah.
You still have to do your structures. So the most of the students, or the students will take most the same classes. It just kind of branches off in your junior year where you doing, whether you're doing astronautics or aeronautics.
Okay, but certainly plenty of opportunity,
right,
I think, in both fields. And
right. You know, some would say, well, why are you going to aerospace? We've already been to the moon. Okay, that's a good one, but there's a lot of things, in my opinion, that we still have not fully explored in aerospace engineering. Yes, we know how to make airplanes, but we have not really hit upon all the things to make that airplane do what we want it to do. The big thing nowadays is hypersonics. That's aerospace, aeronautics. So there's a lot of opportunities still in aerospace engineering, and I think it's a good field to be in.
Yeah. Well, I know we have many opportunities in aerospace engineering for our students to get some hands-on mm-hmm. experience and participate on teams. If you're interested in the astronautic side of things, we have Space Cowboys,
correct,
which has been very successful. But on the aeronautics side, we also have Team Exhibitor,
yep,
which you're the faculty advisor for.
Yep.
Tell us a little bit about Team Exhibitor and what it's done and where you've been and where you're going with
okay.
that.
Team Exhibitor is the student unmanned aircraft design team. We started back in 2003. Let me get that right. Yes, 2003. And basically our mission is to design an autonomous unmanned aircraft to do certain missions. The main mission is, at the time it's called ISR, intelligence, surveillance, and reconnaissance, is to find different targets while this airplane is flying a search pattern. So it's all autonomous. Now we have students that will actually write the code to do the automatic target recognition. We've done that, not as successful as we want it to be. But, you know, we take students from aerospace, obviously, mechanical engineering, computer science, computer engineering, electrical and computing engineering. I've had a geography major on the team at one time. I actually also had an elementary education student on the team, and biomedical engineering. So we're kind of all over, but basically it is a multidisciplinary team to, again, starting back with the aircraft design, you have a set of requirements and then design a system to do those particular requirements. What we have done in the past, obviously with COVID, we haven't been able to go to competition here in the past few years. But one year we did come in first place. We've beaten MIT twice.
Okay.
So I'm pretty proud of that one. But the competition is in Maryland. Actually, it's at Webster Field. It used to be at Webster Field, which is the auxiliary field for NAS Patuxent River. This past year, they moved it to a county airport. And again, since we didn't make it last year, we'll see how that's going to go this
okay.
year. But we've been successful. We've had some highs and lows just about with anything else.
Yeah.
But my main thing is letting the students learn from this type of opportunity. Instead of, you know, being stuck in a classroom looking at equations and so forth and so on, this allows them to do hands-on work from composite manufacturing to aircraft design, computer programming, so forth and so on.
Well, in our closing minute or so here, you mentioned a couple of things that I'd like to follow up on. You and I both grew up in the heyday of NASA manned missions. Now a lot of that has been offloaded to private industry.
Mm-hmm.
We grew up where airplanes were airplanes, and that was pretty much what aeronautical aerospace engineers did. Now we're into the age of drones mm-hmm. and Team Exhibitor. What sort of challenges and future do you see for the industry along those lines?
The big thing is integrating what people call drones. I don't like that word, but that's a personal thing. Integrating unmanned aircraft into the national airspace. That is a big thing that the FAA is working on. Obviously, RASP, part of Assure, is doing that type of work. So I think that's the biggest challenge right now. The other big challenge in aerospace is hypersonics. We're talking about a vehicle that can do Mach 5 plus, and so there's material science involved, aerodynamics, quite obviously propulsion. So a lot of big things coming down the pike, I think, that should motivate our students to find something to get into. So I think the big challenge is in aeronautics is the integration of unmanned aircraft and hypersonics. As far as space is concerned, with the commercialization and so forth and so on, I think it's a good thing.
Okay.
It does give our students other opportunities to get in those type of fields instead of relying upon NASA.
Yeah.
And I'm not knocking NASA, but there are other opportunities for our students to get involved in aerospace engineering.
Okay. Well, sounds like a bright future for aerospace engineering, and we appreciate you taking the time to join us today.
Okay.
And
I
wish
me.
You the best of luck in the semester. I want to thank you all for joining us on Momentum. I look forward to seeing you next month with another edition.